Why does time slow down at high speeds? The speed of light is the same for everyone. If you travel to the nearest star at 90% of the speed of light and came back, everyone on Earth would have aged 9 years, while you aged only 4. Time literally runs slower when you go fast, and GPS satellites prove this is happening right now. Your phone's GPS works because satellites orbiting Earth experience time 38 microseconds faster per day than we do. Without correcting for this tiny difference, your GPS would fall off by 6 miles within a single day. Here's the mind bender though. The speed of light is the same for everyone, no matter how fast you're moving. So when you speed up, time has to slow down to keep light speed constant. It's like the universe's speed limit forces time itself to bend. Scientists have put atomic clocks on airplanes and watched them tick slower than identical clocks on the ground. We're talking billionths of a second, but it's measurable and real. But how is this even possible? Today, we're diving deep into one of Einstein's most revolutionary discoveries, time dilation. We'll explore why time isn't the constant we think it is, how this affects your daily life more than you realize, and what happens when we push the limits of speed to their absolute extreme. Let's say it's 1895, and a 16-year-old Albert Einstein is having the most consequential thought in human history. He's imagining what would happen if you could ride alongside a beam of light. What would you see? The simple thought experiment led to the most mind-blowing realization. The speed of light in a vacuum is always 299,792,458 meters per second. Always. No matter if you're standing still, driving in a car, or flying in a rocket ship at half the speed of light. Light always moves at the same speed relative to you. But wait, if you're driving toward oncoming headlights at 60 miles per hour, shouldn't those light beams be coming at you faster than the speed of light? Nope. And this is where Einstein broke physics and rebuilt it from scratch. Hold on. Before we go further, let me ask you something. Right now, as you're watching this video, you're traveling through space at about 67,000 miles per hour as Earth orbits the sun. Are you feeling any time dilation effects? The answer might surprise you, and we'll get to that in just a minute. So how does the universe solve this impossible equation? If the speed of light must stay constant, but speeds can be added together, something else has to give, right? That something is time itself. Imagine you're on a train throwing a baseball forward at 50 miles per hour while the train moves at 100 miles per hour. To someone on the platform, that baseball is moving at 150 miles per hour. Simple addition, right? But light doesn't play by these rules. If you're on the same train, shining a flashlight forward, the light doesn't travel at the speed of light plus 100 miles per hour. It travels at exactly the speed of light. So what gives? Time stretches, literally. From the perspective of someone on the platform, your clocks on the train start ticking slower. Not because they're broken, but because time itself is running slower for you. This isn't some quirky theory. It's been measured thousands and thousands of times with incredible precision. The formula is surprisingly elegant. Time dilation follows what's called the Lorentz factor. Without getting too mathematical here, here's the key point. The faster you go, the more dramatic the effect becomes. At 50% of the speed of light, time runs about 15% slower. At 90% of the speed of light, it runs at less than half speed. And as you approach the speed of light, time nearly stops from the perspective of someone not moving with you. But the thing is, that you would never feel time slowing down. To you, everything would seem completely normal. Your watch would tick normally. You'd age normally. Everything would feel exactly the same. It's only when you compare your experience to someone who wasn't traveling with you that the difference becomes apparent. Let's talk about the GPS satellites I mentioned earlier. There are about 30 GPS satellites orbiting the Earth right now, each one carrying atomic clocks that are accurate to within a few billionths of a second. These satellites are moving at about 8,700 miles per hour relative to Earth's surface. According to Einstein's equations, this would make their clocks run slower than clocks on Earth. Actually, it's more complicated than that. There are two effects happening simultaneously. First, the satellite speed does make their clocks run slower, about 7 microseconds per day slower. But they are also further from Earth's gravitational field, and gravity also affects time. This makes their clocks run about 45 microseconds per day faster. The net effect, well, satellite clocks run about 38 microseconds faster per day than Earth clocks. That might sound tiny, but remember, GPS works by measuring the time it takes signals to travel from satellites to your phone. Light travels about 1 foot per nanosecond, so even tiny timing errors create massive location errors. Without correcting for time dilation, your GPS would accumulate about 6 miles of error every single day. Your phone would tell you you're in the next town over when you're just trying to find the nearest coffee shop. The most famous experiment demonstrating time dilation was conducted in 1971 by physicists Haffell and Keating. They literally flew atomic clocks around the world on commercial airlines and compared them to identical clocks that stayed on the ground. When they landed, the flying clocks were behind by exactly the amount Einstein's equations predicted, a few hundred billionths of a second. And here's something wild. Particle accelerators like the Large Hadron Collider routinely accelerate particles to 99.9999% the speed of light. At these speeds, particles that normally decay in microseconds can survive for thousands of times longer than normal from our perspective, because time is running so slowly for them. Now, let's explore what happens when we really push the limits. The famous twin paradox illustrates just how dramatic time dilation can become. Imagine identical twins, Alex and Jordan. Jordan stays on Earth, while Alex rockets to Proxima Centauri at 90% of light speed and returns. Earth clocks advance about 9.4 years, while Alex experiences about 4.1 years, a 5-year age gap. At 99%, time runs about 7 times slower for Alex, at 99.9%, about 22 to 1. From Alex's view, Earth's clocks look slow too. The difference only becomes real when Alex turns around and reunites, because that change of direction breaks the symmetry. So, what have we learned? Time isn't the universal constant we intuitively believe it to be. It's flexible, malleable, and intimately connected to motion and gravity. Every time you move, you're literally traveling through time at a slightly different rate than someone else standing still. The universe has a speed limit, the speed of light, and it enforces that limit by stretching and compressing time itself. If you could somehow observe the entire universe from outside space and time, what would you see? All of history, past, present, and future exist simultaneously. Some physicists think so. What aspect of time dilation fascinates you most? Have you ever wondered what it would be like to experience extreme time dilation firsthand? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you enjoy diving deep into Einstein's universe, you'll love our video on black holes and how they warp space-time even more dramatically.